For lab one, you'll need to know some structures from the torso model, including what system those structures are in and what cavities those structures are in. We will start from the neck region and go down. So in the neck region here, we have the larynx here and here. The larynx is part of the respiratory system. This bluish tube here and here is the trachea, also part of the respiratory system. Pinkish structure here is the thyroid gland, part of the endocrine system. Then we go down to the thoracic cavity. Within the thoracic cavity, we have the lungs. Lungs are also in the pleural cavities. Move the lungs. You can see the heart part of the cardiovascular system, and also in the pericardial cavity and the mediastinum. This here red structure here is the aorta, part of the cardiovascular system, and also in the mediastinum. Remove this. Behind that, we can see the esophagus, part of the digestive system, and also in the mediastinum. Then we go down to the abdominal cavity. Then the abdominal cavity, we have the stomach here, stomach, part of the digestive system, the liver, part of the digestive system. On the posterior side of the liver, we see the green gallbladder, also part of the digestive system. We take the stomach out. We see posterior to it is the pancreas. The pancreas is part of the digestive system and the endocrine system. Then we have the large intestine in gray going around. The large intestine is part of the digestive system. Then we have the small intestine, also part of the digestive system. Taking these out, we can see hanging off the end of the large intestine is the appendix, technically part of the digestive system. Remove all this. In the posterior wall, we can see the two kidneys, part of the urinary system, and the spleen, part of the lymphatic system. We also need to get a good view of the diaphragm, this sheet-like muscle that separates the thoracic cavity from the abdominal cavity. And if we go way down to the pelvic cavity, we can see the urinary bladder.